to stop it, so you can.
Yeah, I'll just sign them between seeing people. Looks like if only get two or three interpreter cases. Just so that you know, you probably won't be here all morning.
Yes, ma'am.
All afternoon. He can come on in, I can sign these between inmates. Sir, do you need an interpreter?
Necesito usted un intérprete, señor.
Sí.
Yes.
Could you tell me your name?
¿Me puede decir su nombre?
Joseph Borrero Colón.
Joseph Borrero Colón.
Mr. Borrero Colón, you have been arrested on an outstanding warrant.
Señor Colón, usted ha sido arrestado por una orden de arresto pendiente.
For violating the conditions of your pretrial release.
Por incumplir las condiciones de su libertad prejudicial.
No bond has been set.
No se ha programado fianza.
Do you already have the public defender in this matter?
¿Ya usted ha sido asignado al defensor público en este asunto?
No.
No.
I will appoint the public defender temporarily to represent you.
Voy a asignar las oficinas al defensor público de manera provisional para que lo represente.
Okay. Do you have any questions?
¿Tiene usted alguna otra pregunta?
No me va a dar bond hoy ni nada.
So there's no bond today or anything?
There's no bond today.
No hay fianza en el día de hoy.
Okay. Any other questions?
¿Alguna otra pregunta?
No, no podría ni con electrónica.
You couldn't do it even electronically?
No.
No.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
Gracias, que tenga buen día.
Sir, could you tell me your name?
Caballero, ¿me puede dar su nombre?
Luis Iván Rodríguez Meléndez.
Luis Iván Rodríguez Meléndez.
Sir, you have been arrested for burglary of a dwelling.
Señor, usted ha sido arrestado por allanamiento de morada.
Grand theft third degree.
Hurto mayor tercer grado.
And criminal mischief.
Y travesura penal.
I do find probable cause for your arrest.
Determino que existe un motivo fundado para su arresto.
It appears that you qualify for the services of the public defender.
Parece que usted cumple requisitos para la representación del defensor público.
I will appoint them to represent you.
Los voy a asignar para que los representen a usted.
There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days.
Se debe pagar unos $50 por la solicitud del defensor público antes de que se cumpla 60 días.
Bond is stayed in the amount of $2,500 on count one.
En el primer cargo se programa una fianza de $2,500.
$1,000 on count two.
$1,000 en el segundo cargo.
And $500 on count three.
Y $500 en el tercer cargo.
You will not return to the scene of the alleged offense.
No se le permite regresar al lugar de los acontecimientos.
And you will have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim.
Y no se le permitirá contacto en absoluto con la presunta víctima.
Do you have any questions, sir?
¿Tiene usted alguna pregunta, caballero?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
No.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Gracias, que tenga buen día.
Sir, could you tell me your name?
Caballero, ¿me puede dar su nombre?
Rubén Zavala.
Rubén Zavala.
Sí.
Yes.
Sir, you were arrested for possession of cocaine and possession of drug paraphernalia.
Señor, usted fue arrestado por poseer cocaína y poseer parafernalia de drogas.
And for driving without a valid driver's license.
Y conducir sin portar licencia válida de conducir.
I do find probable cause for your arrest in these matters.
Determino que existe un motivo fundado para su arresto en estos asuntos.
Bond is stayed in the amount of $1,000 on the possession of cocaine.
Se programa una fianza de $1,000 en el cargo de posesión de cocaína.
$500 on the possession of paraphernalia.
$500 en el cargo de poseer parafernalia de drogas.
And $500 on the no valid driver's license.
Y $500 en el cargo de no portar licencia válida de conducir.
I will authorize your release on pretrial release.
Le voy a permitir su libertad bajo el programa de libertad vigilada.
So you can choose whether you want to postpone or you don't want to postpone, but you want pretrial release.
Y usted puede decidir, puede pagar la fianza o puede salir sin fianza, pero bajo las condiciones de libertad prejudicial.
And I will appoint the public defender temporarily to represent you.
Le voy a asignar las oficinas del defensor público de manera provisional para que lo representen.
Is there any conditions?
Su señoría, ¿existen condiciones?
Yes.
Sí.
As either a condition of bond or pretrial release.
Como condición de fianza o de libertad prejudicial.
You will not drive without a valid driver's license.
No se le permite conducir sin tener licencia válida de conducir.
As a condition of pretrial release, if that is the path you choose.
Y como condición de libertad prejudicial, si es que usted decide hacerlo de esa manera.
You will undergo random drug screening.
Va a tener que hacerse pruebas de drogas al azar.
Any other questions from PTR?
¿Alguna otra pregunta, libertad prejudicial?
So, I'm making sure I'm correct. If he's released on PTR, if that's what he chooses, he must have a random drug screen.
And not drive without a valid license.
Entonces, para estar seguro, si él escoge salir bajo libertad provisional, tiene que hacerse pruebas de orina al azar, sí, y no puede conducir.
So if he chooses the bond, is that the same conditions or no?
Si él decide salir bajo fianza, ¿serán las mismas condiciones o no?
If he chooses bond, he simply can't drive without a valid driver's license. I'm not going to require PTR to do drug screening.
Okay.
Si él sale bajo fianza, simplemente le indico que no se le permite conducir, pero no le voy a exigir las pruebas de orina al azar.
Does that answer your question? All right. Do you have any questions, sir?
¿Tiene usted alguna otra pregunta, caballero?
No. Yo
no.
Puedo.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
Gracias. Que tenga buen día.
You don't want these, right? I can throw them away when I'm done.
Oh, no. They've
got to
go back.
They go back to them. Gotcha. Okay.
Your Honor, does the court require any further assistance from the interpreter this morning?
I don't think so. There are no more Spanish interpreter cases.
May the interpreter be excused, Your Honor.
Yes, you may.
Thank you. Have a good weekend.
I will. You too.
Have a good weekend all.
Sir, could you tell me your name?
45432.
I need you to speak up a little. I can't hear you.
G45432.
All right. Are you Mr. Grant?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Mr. Grant, you were arrested on an outstanding warrant for burglary of a dwelling. There was probable cause for your arrest. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. There is a bond. I'm going to stay bond on the burglary charge at $15,000. I am going to order that you have no contact with the alleged victims and that you not return to the scene of the alleged offense. Do you have any questions, sir?
Yeah, I've been charged with got out of prison and I've been charged with burglary for what for? I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But I just let you know, I don't know what they're talking about burglary.
And we're not going to decide that issue today.
But it's chill out up in here, man.
Sir, could you tell me your name?
Marcel Braddock, BRG.
Is this Rivera? Oh.
Sir, could you tell me your name?
Rivera Izzy.
All right, Mr. Rivera, you have been arrested on an outstanding warrant for interfering with custody of a minor and luring or enticing a child. There is probable cause for your arrest. I will stay bond on that case in the amount of $2,500 on count one and $1,000 on count two.
Your Honor, may I be heard on the out on bond case?
You may, but I'm not there yet.
Okay. I'll wait for when you're ready.
If you do post bond, I will require that you have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim and that you not return to the scene of the offense. Now, you are out on bond on 2018 CF-12015.
Your Honor, he's
and I do understand that he might have a competency issue with regard to that matter.
Right, he's not on bond. He's on conditional release. He's already been adjudicated incompetent to proceed, so I was going to ask for you to take no action on that case. Given
well, obviously, the conditional release needs additional conditions.
Right.
So I am going to revoke his release in that matter and require that this matter be examined by the judge that is assigned to the case.
Are you setting it at none?
I'm setting it at none until he is seen by the judge that has 2018 CF-12015. I will appoint the public defender to represent him on the new case. I suspect your office already represents him on the other.
Yes, by Mr. Spencer, our
there
competency
There is a $50
attorney.
Application fee. It'll be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions? All right, thank you. Tell me your name.
Javier Torres.
Mr. Torres, you were arrested for attempted sexual battery on a person 18 years of age or older and battery. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. You are entitled to bond with regard to those matters. I'm going to set bond on count one in the amount of $30,000. I'm going to set bond on count two in the amount of $5,000 with the conditions that you have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim and that you not return to the scene of the alleged offense. You are out on bond on 2021 MM505. I'm going to revoke your bond in that case and have you held on no bond. I will appoint the public defender to represent you on both cases.
He already has PD,
already has PD in the misdemeanor. All right, I will appoint the public defender to represent you on the new felony case. Mm-hmm. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
No.
All right, thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right, cool. Thank you.
Your Honor,
Carl
Williams is mental health.
All right. Let's see. Public defender, do you want me to, he does not qualify for PTR, does he?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Do you want me to reset this?
Would it be for tomorrow or Monday?
Probably Monday.
We'll waive his appearance.
All right. I will temporarily appoint the public defender to represent Mr. Williams. I do find probable cause for his arrest on the possession of cocaine on the warrant issued by Judge Schreiber. And in light of his significant criminal history and history of failures to appear, I will stay bond in the amount of $1,000.
Miles Workman, Your Honor?
Yes.
Mental health as well.
You said Workman?
Workman, mental health.
Okay.
you want me to reset Workman or do you want to?
We can waive.
All right. I will appoint the public defender to represent Mr. Workman as he does qualify. $50 application fee due within 60 days. I do find probable cause for his arrest on battery on a law enforcement officer, battery on a uniform or security officer resisting with violence and trespass. I will stay bond at the amounts presently set in light of his significant history, criminal history and significant history of failures to appear. Are you Mr. Alford?
Yes, ma'am.
Could you tell me your name?
Justin Joseph Alford.
Mr. Alford, you were arrested for battery. I do find probable cause for your arrest. Mm-hmm. You also qualify for the public defender. I will appoint them to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Okay. I will stay bond in the amount of $500. With the condition that you have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim and you not return to the scene where it is alleged to have occurred.
Okay.
And I don't believe you qualify for pretrial release. Do you have any questions, sir?
No, I don't.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day. Could you tell me your name?
Hiram Fordhams.
All right. Mr. Fordhams, you have been arrested. Give me just a minute. Get back there. You've been arrested on petty theft, first degree. Mm-hmm. I do find probable cause for your arrest. Bond is set at $500 on that case, and I will order that you have no contact with the alleged victim and you not return to the scene of that offense. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It'll be due within 60 days. You are out on bond on 2020 CF11270 and 2020 CF10740. I am going to revoke your bond in those cases in order that you be held on no bond on those two cases. Do you have any questions, sir?
No.
All right, thank you. Have a good day. Could you tell me your name?
Cecil Rolando Punta Jr., Your Honor.
All right, Mr. Punter, you were arrested on an out-of-county warrant out of Osceola County for violation of a domestic violence injunction. No bond was set on that warrant. I will appoint the public defender to represent you since it's the same office in both Orange and Osceola counties. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
So I can't be bailed out under warrant?
You cannot, no. Not until you get back to Osceola County and have a bond hearing.
Okay, one more question, Your Honor. I bonded out already for Orange County because I was locked up from December 27.
Yeah, if you bonded in Orange, they will transport you to Osceola.
All right, thank you.
All right, thank you. Have a good day.
Michael Thomas.
Mr. Thomas, you were arrested on an out-of-county warrant from Seminole County. The warrant was issued for possession of methamphetamine. The judge in Seminole County set a bond in the amount of $3,000 on the warrant. I will at least temporarily appoint the public defender to represent you until you get transported to Seminole. Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
You too.
You had called previous Ruben Zavalar Roberio when we was discussing whether he's going to get bond or PTR, he already bonded out around 10:33.
Okay, he already bonded. Thank you. Can we have the name again, please?
Yes, ma'am. Ruben.
Thank you, Breezy P.I.G.
Zavala.
He was one of the interpreter cases.
That was the first case we did. I don't know. I already sent it downstairs.
Okay.
I'll have to ask them. Because we actually heard his case, so I think he's still in paperwork.
All right. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Marcel Braddock, B.R.G.
All right. Mr. Braddock, you were arrested on a trespass. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It'll be due within 60 days. Does he qualify for mental health pretrial release? I'm sorry?
Let me check for you.
Okay.
I wanted to know if I'd be able to go home to my daughter today.
Well, that's what we're talking about. And she's going to check to see if you qualify for mental health pretrial release.
He already have a detainer here to D.C. So we have to wait on the information back with the mental health doctor.
Okay. Now what I will... I will stay bond in the amount of $250. However, if you qualify for pretrial release or mental health pretrial release, I will authorize that you be released on those without having to come see me again.
So I'm not going home today?
I don't know yet because they have to finish processing your paperwork.
Right. He does not qualify for just straight pretrial release. So if you want to say pretrial for mental health,
so he does not qualify for regular pretrial. All right.
So you
want to
say bond or mental health pretrial?
Yeah. So it'll be bond or mental health pretrial release because he does not qualify for pretrial release. You cannot, sir, because you're out on bond. I'm not going to take any action on that bond case, but you would not be able to plea right now and be guaranteed that you would get out of custody.
So when will I be going home?
They're gonna evaluate you for mental health pretrial release, or you can post a bond of $250.
They said that the bond was $150, 15%, and $15.
It's the bond is $250, and if you go to a bondsman, you'll have to find out what his fee would be. It's usually about 10%.
Could you just dismiss everything and I go home today to my wife?
No, sir, I can't do that.
Because I'm innocent. I didn't do anything wrong.
Well, that's what a trial would be for. And we're not doing the trial today.
So when's the trial going to be?
I don't know. That's not why we're here today. We're here for initial appearance.
But if the trial's not for 30 days, that means I stay in the jail 30 days?
If the state files charges, then you'll have an arraignment, and the judge that's assigned to the case will tell you when your trial is. All right.
When's the next time I will be due for a bail hearing?
You've got the public defender appointed to represent you. The public defender can schedule a hearing.
This is ridiculous.
I let your attorneys know that you're here.
I don't have any money or family to bond out. I make love to my wife, Breezy. I want to go home to my wife, Breezy.
All right. I understand that, sir. Have a good day.
How long before I go home?
I cannot tell you that.
This is bullshit.
Could you tell me your name, please, sir?
Eric Anthony Derville.
Mr. Derville, you have been arrested for throwing a deadly missile at a person and domestic violence battery. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. You are entitled to bond. So I will set bond on the throwing a deadly missile in the amount of $2,500 and $500 on the battery. If you're able to post bond in this case, you'll have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim and not return to the scene of the offense.
Yes, ma'am.
You are out on bond on 2020 CF-13009. I'm going to revoke your bond in that case and order that you be held on no bond.
Your Honor, may I be heard on the out on bond?
He's charged with trafficking, counsel, and possession of a firearm in the commission of a felony.
Yes, I understand that, Your Honor. He was arrested on October 29th, and I'm asking you to use your discretion to not revoke his bond because no charges have been filed in that case.
I'm going to revoke his bond. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Have a good day, sir. Could you tell me your name?
Luis Angel Lopez Cruz.
Sir, you were arrested on an outstanding warrant for tampering with a witness and domestic violence battery. I do find probable cause for your arrest. Does he qualify for pretrial release?
No, ma'am.
You are entitled to bond on these charges. And I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. It'll be due within 60 days. State, do you wish to be heard with regard to the matter of release?
No, Your Honor. The state will defer to the court's discretion.
Defense?
Your Honor, we ask that you set reasonable bonds in these counts. For the tampering a witness, I'd say $1,000 and then $500, $100 on the rest.
I will set bond in count one in the amount of $1,500 and on count two in the amount of $500. If you are able to post bond, you will have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim and you will not return to the scene of the offense. Do you have any questions, sir?
Does this count from other cases?
I'm sorry?
We're not addressing the other cases today. You already have them. Okay. They've been addressed.
Okay, thank you.
Can you tell me your name?
Carl Lovett.
Mr. Lovett, you were arrested for aggravated assault with a deadly weapon and battery. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. You are entitled to bond, so I will be setting bond or other conditions of release. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. It'll be due within 60 days. State, do you wish to be heard with regard to the amount of conditions of release?
Your Honor, the state would defer to the court for what is reasonable for bond.
Thank you. Defense?
Your Honor, it appears he qualifies for pretrial release. The defense would be asking he be released on pretrial release.
All right. And does he qualify?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Then I will order that you be released on pretrial release. If you would prefer to post bond rather than pretrial release, I'll set bond on count one in the amount of $2,500 and on count two in the amount of $500. Regardless of whether you post bond or are released on pretrial release, you will have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim. You will not return to the scene of the offense. Do you have personal belongings there?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
All right, I will order that you be permitted to return one time with law enforcement to retrieve your personal belongings. Do you have any questions, sir?
None, Your Honor.
All right, thank you. Have a good day.
And you said no return, right?
No return, yes.
Right here?
Except one time. Not as many DVs today, which is a good thing.
Yes.
Can you tell me your name? Ma'am, could you tell me your name?
Elaine McKnight.
Ms. McKnight, you were arrested for domestic violence battery. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. You are entitled to a bond or other conditions of release, so I will be setting those in just a minute. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. State, do you wish to be heard with regard to the matter of release?
No, Your Honor, the state would defer to the court for reasonable bond.
Thank you. Defense?
Your Honor, we'd be asking for a $500 bond and a one-time return with law enforcement.
Ma'am.
One moment.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
All right. Ma'am, I will set bond in this matter in the amount of $500 with the following conditions. You will have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim. You will not return to the scene of the offense. I will permit you to return one time with law enforcement to retrieve any personal belongings.
All right.
Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
So my bond is what? Okay, I got a bond. But if I pay the whole, I can pay the whole thing. I'm so nervous. But what are we talking about, 60 days? They should even pay for me all that.
They will.
Ma'am, could you tell me your name?
Fina Perez.
Ms. Perez, you were arrested for stalking. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. You are entitled, bond is set in the amount of $1,000. I will require that you have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim and that you not return to the scene of the offense. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
Yes, ma'am. I'm scared. Yeah, hi, ma'am. I was not stalking. I was on
the... All right, you may not want to...
She already posted her bond.
She's already posted bond?
Yes.
Okay. It's already posted. Right. It came in as no bond, so.
They corrected it
to no bond. So I set it at 1,000, yes. And you'll be able to bond at this point, but you have those conditions. All right. Thank you.
That did confuse me.
Yeah. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Your Honor, Marcus Allers, behavior.
Okay. He qualifies for the public defender. Do you want me to do the IA?
Yes, I can waive his appearance at IA. I did have a probable cause challenge as to the burglary of a dwelling count.
Okay. Yeah, we'll get to you in just a minute. I will appoint the public defender to represent Mr. Allers. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Thank you. And I will hear from the assistant public defender with regard to the burglary charge, and I will need to hear from the state with regard to count 5, the city ordinance violation, failure to ID.
Your Honor, as to the burglary of a dwelling, it appears, according to the facts of the case, that he was accused of breaking into Exploria Stadium. So the proper charge would be burglary of a structure, and the bond would be significantly lower for burglary of a structure. So I'd ask that you find no probable cause for burglary of a dwelling. And I would object to being at reset because the stadium, the definition of a burglary of a dwelling won't change over the course of 24 hours.
State, do you wish to be heard with regard to count 5?
The state normally doesn't deal with city cases, Your Honor, so I'm...
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good enough.
Okay.
With regard to count one, I do not find probable cause for burglary of a dwelling, but I do find probable cause for burglary of a structure. Bond as to the burglary of a structure will be set at $2,000. On count one. I do find probable cause for counts 2, 3, and 4. I find no probable cause for count 5. I will stay bond at $100 on counts 2, 3, and 4. Obviously, there will be ROR on count 5. If he is released, he's to have no contact with the alleged victims and not return to the scene of the offense.
ROR, no PT on count 5.
Yes.
By chance, for count one, burglary.
It's going to be 810.02. I can give it to you.
Okay.
I don't have their magic little codes there, like the 19 and stuff like that, that have absolutely no application to
thank you.
All right, that was Mr. Allers. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Denzel Art.
You're going to have to speak up a little bit.
Denzel Art.
All right, Mr. Art, you were arrested for driving, well, license revoked or suspended as a habitual offender. I do find probable cause for your arrest in that matter. Bond is set at $2,500 on that count. I will order that you not drive without a valid driver's license. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee.
No problem.
You are out on bond on 2020 CT 1644. State you wish to be heard. That's a driving while license suspended with knowledge.
Your Honor, the state would just request that the bond be set at a reasonable amount.
I can't hear you.
I apologize. The state requests that the bond be set at a reasonable amount, given the conditions from the prior bond in 2020 CT 1644.
Thank you. And do you know what the bond was in that case or conditions?
I can check right.
It was a PTR.
It was PTR. Ah, okay. Wow. Thank you. Let me hear from the defense.
Your Honor, I would ask that you take no action on this case so he has an opportunity to fix his driver's license. He won't be able to fix it from the inside of the jail. If you're not inclined to take no action, I would ask that you at least set a new bond.
All right. I am going to revoke his pretrial release in 2020 CT 1644 AW. I will set bond in the amount of $2,000 with the same condition that you not drive without a valid driver's license. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Denzel Art.
Oh.
Oh, I'm so sorry. That was my fault.
Your Honor, Daniel Benchamo has bonded.
Okay, thank you. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Sean Michael Davis.
Mr. Davis, you were arrested on an outstanding warrant for petty theft, having two prior theft convictions, and on a failure to appear in 2020 MM8874. In the misdemeanor case, bond was set in the amount of $500 on count one and $500 on count two. In the felony case, bond is set in the amount of $2,500. I'm going to require that you not return to the scene of the offense.
Yes, ma'am.
And that you have no contact with the alleged victims. I will appoint the public defender to represent you in each of these matters if they don't already represent you in the misdemeanor.
They do, Your Honor.
They do? All right. Then I'll appoint them in the felony.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. Ms. Daly was my public defender for the misdemeanor cases, and I was given a 33-day motion. Is there any way I could solve those since they're misdemeanors?
No, sir, not today.
So I have to wait once again?
Yes, you do.
Okay, I wasn't, I didn't, because of holiday season and me trying to find work when I was released after my motion, I just wasn't able to figure out when my court date was. And I'm a veteran, I'm having a tough situation.
And you can explain that to the judge that issued the warrant.
A bond motion?
Yep, for ROR. That's what I'm going to try to get you to do.
There are...
Yes.
But not, it won't happen today.
Nothing can be resolved today?
Mm-mm.
Not even misdemeanors?
No, yep. Because of the
petty
theft.
As petty as that is.
As I indicated, I'll appoint the public defender to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. It will be due within 10 days.
Well, thank you for your service.
60 days,
Y'all have a blessed day.
All right, you too.
God bless America.
Could you tell me your name?
My name is Frederick Dawson, ma'am.
Mr. Dawson?
Yes, ma'am.
You were arrested on an outstanding warrant for failure to appear.
Yes, ma'am.
And it looks like it was issued in Division 15 on the underlying charge of tampering with physical evidence.
Okay.
The judge set no bond on that failure to appear. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
But basically, I don't really, I thought I had, I went to the, I don't know. No, ma'am.
All right.
I guess they're terrible.
Yeah, and if you have questions, you can call the public defender's office to get answers.
So, how long do I have to stay here before they see me, you know?
I think the public defender that's in the courtroom could tell you that.
I'm letting your attorney know as right now.
Okay, thank you. I'm fine.
All right, thank you, sir. Can you tell me your name, please, sir?
My name is Prince Hall.
Mr. Hall, you were arrested for possession of methamphetamine and resisting an officer without violence. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. I will stay bond in the amount of $1,000 on the possession and $100 on the resisting without violence. I will temporarily appoint the public defender to represent you since I don't have an affidavit. Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
Your Honor, Alex Harrison.
Uh-huh.
Behavior.
All right. Let me take a look. Do you want me to temporarily appoint your office? I don't have an affidavit, he didn't fill it out.
Yes, temporarily appoint our office, and we can reset this one for Monday.
All right. I will temporarily appoint the public defender. I'll reset Mr. Harrison for IA on Monday. However, I will indicate on the record that I do find probable cause for his arrest and detention.
Your Honor, William Harwell?
Yes.
Harwell, he's refused.
All right, let me look at him.
Your Honor, we can waive this one. It's a failure to appear.
All right. I will temporarily appoint the public defender to represent Mr. Harrell if they don't already represent him. He failed to appear and a capias was issued. $10,000 bond was set on the capias, and I will stay the bond at that amount. Could you tell me your name?
Michael David Neal, ma'am.
Mr. Neal,
yes,
you were arrested on a couple of things, so let me lay it out in front of me. You have a failure to appear on a petty theft, and that was issued in case number 2020 CF 10262. No bond was set on that. The underlying charge is petty theft having two prior theft convictions. I also find, let me look. Looks like you were out on bond or pretrial release in 2020 CF 10184.
No, ma'am. Bond, I don't bond?
Yes, the charge was petty theft having two prior theft convictions.
Yes, ma'am, that's all I have.
All right, so you got two of those now.
I didn't commit one now. I mean, I just got picked up for failure to appear. I didn't commit a charge.
Yes, he's correct, Your Honor. He has a failure to appear on a petty theft two priors. That's what he's here for. But he is also out on bond for a different petty theft two priors.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
Two different case numbers.
Yes.
Yes. I am going to revoke your bond in the...
Excuse me, ma'am. When you say I don't bond, I never bonded out.
I'll revoke your bond or release on 2020 CF 10184.
Your Honor, may I be heard?
You may.
Your Honor, would you be inclined to set a new bond considering he did not violate the conditions of the it's a failure to appear, so he didn't pick up a new charge and violate the conditions of his release. He only violated the conditions of release, in the case that he has a failure to appear in. Am I making sense?
Let me look at something.
Sure.
The new case, because I know when the old case happened. Not the old.
Your Honor, are you looking for the dates that they were filed?
It appears that 10162 occurred in June, so I'm going to take no action on 10162.
No, you mean you're going to take no action on 10184?
Oh, well, let me look at 10184. I'm looking at that case number there.
Right. No, the argument I was making is he failed to appear in 10262, so he violated the conditions of his release in that case, and that's why there's a no bond failure to appear, but he did not violate the conditions of release in 2020 CF 10184. He didn't pick up a new charge, he just failed to appear in the new case.
new charge, 10184, happened after 10262. 10262 happened in June, 10184 happened in August.
Right, I understand what you're saying. Okay, sorry.
Stop. So I'm gonna take no action on 10184, since it occurred after 10262. But bond will still be no bond on 10262. And I will appoint the public defender. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. All right, do you have any questions, sir?
No, ma'am.
Thank you.
Your Honor, James Nesmith, refused.
Okay. Counsel, do you want him brought back, or?
No, it appears it's just a failure to appear with new charges, so we can wait.
All right, I'll appoint the public defender temporarily to represent Mr. Neesmith. In 2020 CF 9040, he was arrested for failure to appear. I will stay bonds as they are set on the capias. In 2021 CF 1486, he was arrested for burglary of a structure, criminal mischief, and trespass. I do find probable cause for his arrest in those matters. I will stay bond as set on that case, with the additional condition that he not return to the scene and have no contact whatsoever with the alleged victim. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Jacob Perez.
Mr. Perez, you were arrested for, let me get the two cases separated. Give me just a minute. In 2021 CF 1493, for possession of a firearm by convicted felon and possession of ammunition by a convicted felon. In 2021 CF 1494, you were arrested for possession of ammunition by a convicted felon, possession of cocaine with intent to sell or distribute, possession of amphetamine with intent to sell or distribute, possession of fentanyl, and possession of drug paraphernalia. I do find probable cause for your arrest. You do qualify for the public defender, so I will appoint them to represent you in this matter. There is a $60 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. I will stay bonds as they are presently set. In 2021, CF 1493, at 4,000 on count one and 150 on count two. And in 2021 CF 1494, in the amount of 5,000 on count one, 15,000 on count two, 150 on each on three and four, and $100 on count five. Do you have any questions? Any questions? All right, thank you. Could you tell me your name?
Alfredo Santiago Rivera, ma'am.
Mr. Rivera, you were arrested for possession of methamphetamine and possession of drug paraphernalia in 2021 CF 1495, and in 2021 that doesn't make any sense. What is that case? Oh, this is an out-of-county warrant. And you were arrested on an out-of-county. Let me look. This doesn't look like an out-of-county warrant. It is not an out-of-county warrant, unless it's Osceola. Let me look.
I see something?
Here. I've got it here. Let me look. I think it's Osceola. Yep. but the case number, that's the case number there, not that. Okay. Yeah. And the second case number is 2021 CF 1506. It is a warrant for possession of methamphetamine and possession of paraphernalia. Bond was set in the amount of $1,000 on count one in that case and $500 on count two. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me your name, please, sir.
Jordan DeAndre Trent.
So you're Jordan Trent, right?
Yes.
Mr. Trent, you are arrested for possession of methamphetamine. I do find probable cause for your arrest. Bond was set in the amount of $1,500 on that case. You are also arrested in 2021 CF 1467 for possession of methamphetamine. Bond was set in the amount of $1,000 on that case. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
Yeah.
Yes, sir?
What was the second case I was arrested for?
A second possession of methamphetamine and a possession of paraphernalia.
Possession of paraphernalia and...
Well, no, it's actually just a possession of methamphetamine. I'm sorry. Two different cases of possession of methamphetamine. One happened on February 5th at 3, and one happened on February 5th at 6:42.
All right.
All right?
Okay.
Have a good day.
Okay.
Could you tell me your name?
Wilfredo Velez.
What happened to Mr. Trochet? Carlise Marquis Trochet?
I don't have that one either. He might have already bonded if PTR wouldn't mind looking.
Do I have a booking number? I don't. I may. Don't know.
$2,100, 3047.
Okay, great. Thank you. Mr. Velez, you were arrested for several traffic offenses, those being reckless driving, fleeing, or attempting to elude a law enforcement officer with lights and sirens activated.
Give me 1 second. This is Mr. Velez.
Yes.
His attorney wants to dial in.
Oh, you're transporting virtually.
He's got a private attorney. All right. Well, we can move to something else while we're waiting for him, unless he's on the line. Good afternoon now. Could I have the attorney on the phone identify themselves for the record, please?
Allison Carestes for the defendant.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Carestes. If I could have the state attorney identify herself, please.
Wendy Gaskins for the state.
Thank you. And Ms. Carestes, just so you know, this is Judge Munyon doing IAs today. Mr. Velez was arrested on reckless driving, fleeing and attempting to elude with lights and sirens activated, delivery of controlled substances, and resisting an officer without violence. I do find probable cause for his arrest in this matter. You are entitled to bond on this new case, which is 2021 CF 1508. Ms. Carestes, do you represent him on the new case or only on the old cases?
We have not yet filed a notice of appearance on the new case, but we intend to represent him on the new case.
Okay. Do you wish to be heard with regard to the amount of bond on the new case? I do recognize that he has two other cases that I will be addressing.
I would just ask you to set it according to the bond schedule, Judge.
All right. With regard to the reckless driving, I will set bond in the amount of $500. With regard to the fleeing and attempting to elude with lights and sirens activated, I will set bond in the amount of $7,500. With regard to the delivery, I will set bond in the amount of $7,500. And with regard to the resisting without, I'll set bond in the amount of $500. You are presently out on bond on 2020 CF108 and 2020 CF6937. I am going to revoke your bond in those cases in order that you be held at no bond until you see the judges assigned to those cases.
Yes, ma'am.
Anything else on this matter?
No, ma'am.
No, Your Honor.
All right. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Well, I can't end the call. It won't let me. There we go. Count one of which one?
The first one is what we're striving.
All right. I said it 500. Thank you.
Your Honor, Carl Williams is mental health.
Carl Williams. He's not the next one on my list. Next one is Mitchell Lane. I don't think I got an issue for that guy. Mm-hmm. Could you tell me your name?
I'm Mitchell Lane.
Mr. Lane, you were arrested for failure to appear for trial on a battery. No bond was set on that battery charge, failure to appear. Do you already have the public defender?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Then there's no need to appoint them again to represent you in that case. Do you have any questions?
Am I allowed to get a bond?
No, sir, you don't get a bond. The judge that is assigned to your case set no bond, and I am not going to change that.
Okay. All right.
Thank you. Can you tell me your name?
Gary Cosgrove.
All right. What happened to Mr. Alves? I can't say his name. Albi Zureta.
We don't have one down.
You want the inmate number?
Yes, ma'am.
It is 2100-3046.
Find
it. All right. Thank you. All right, Mr. Cosgrove, you have been arrested for driving under the influence. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. Bond is set in the amount of $500. I'm going to order that you not drive without a valid driver's license and that you not consume alcoholic beverages while you're out on bond. Do you have any questions?
No.
All right. You do qualify for the public defender. Do you want me to appoint them to represent you?
Please.
I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any questions?
No.
All right. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Tell me your name.
Matthew Chisholm.
Mr. Chisholm, give me just a moment. I got too many papers here. You were arrested for exposure of sexual organs, trespass, and resisting an officer without violence. I do find probable cause for your arrest in this matter. Bond is stayed in the amount of $500 on count one and $100 each on counts two and three. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. You're presently out on bond in 2020 CF12000 for possession of fentanyl. I will revoke your bond in that matter and order that you be held on no bond. You are also out on bond on 2021 MM411 for misusing the 911 or E911 system. I will revoke your bond in that matter and order that you be held on no bond pending seeing the judges that are assigned to those cases. Do you have any questions?
Nope. Your Honor, we're not appointed on the CF case. Would you appoint us to that case as well?
Yes. I will appoint the public defender on the CF case as well.
Thank you.
And impose the $50 application fee. Okay. Thank you, sir. Have a good day. Could you tell me your name?
Christopher Hungria.
Mr. Hungria?
Yeah.
Give me just a moment to get your paperwork here. You were arrested for violation of FWC regulations and that you possessed a reticulated python. I can honestly say in my 18 years as a judge, it's the first time I've seen that one.
We were doing a photo shoot. We're here for the Super Bowl.
You don't want to, you really don't want to talk about the facts of the case.
I'm sorry. I know it's rare.
Yep. And in doing that, you violated several Florida statutes that require a stamp and other things to have exotic animals.
Yeah.
So I do find probable cause for your arrest. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There's a $50 application fee. Bond is, he does not qualify for PTR?
No,
All right. I will set bond in the amount of $500 on count one and $200 each on counts two and three. Do you have any questions?
Am I able to?
What?
Can I speak to her about it or is it to you?
It depends on what the question is. Why don't you ask her first?
Judge, Mr. Hungary is asking if you'd be inclined to release him on his own recognizance, considering their misdemeanors.
I am not. He has prior failures to appear, and looks like he might also have fish and wildlife violations in the past.
Is there an offer from the state?
I would not, with the prior record, I would not be
okay.
Taking a plea
she
on that today.
She won't accept
a plea today, so we're
going to have to wait.
Yes.
Thank you.
Tell me your name.
Jesse Montooth.
All right, what happened to Austin McCummin?
Your Honor, he is mental health.
All right. Do we want to deal with Mr. McCummin?
I would ask to reset since this, unless Your Honor would waive or would release him on his own recognizance without his presence. I know some judges don't feel comfortable releasing someone on ROR, but I know this is the type of charge that he could get ROR on since he doesn't have any criminal history. So I guess reset it, please.
I'll reset it for tomorrow to see if he's any better. Mr. Montooth, you were arrested for disorderly conduct and disorderly intoxication. I do find probable cause for your arrest. Bond was set in the amount of $500 on count one and $100 on count two. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It'll be due within 60 days.
Your Honor, it's the state's non-monetary bond policy to advocate for ROR in cases of city ordinances and non-violent misdemeanors. Would you be inclined to release him on his own recognizance, given that they're city cases?
These are not city cases. These are not.
Oh, it can be charged. I'm sorry. They can be charged as city. They.
Yeah.
I normally see them as city cases.
Yeah.
But
these are not city cases. They're violations of Florida statute.
They're still non-violent misdemeanors. Would you be inclined to release them on its own recognizance?
Let's see. He's only got one prior failure to appear, but does not qualify for PTR. I will reduce the bond on count one to $100 and stay bond at $100 on count two.
Okay. Thank you.
Tell me your name.
Alvin Sanders.
Mr. Sanders, you were arrested on several different things. Let me get them all spread out here for me. In 2021 MM856, you were arrested for resisting an officer without violence and loitering and prowling. I do find probable cause for your arrest in that matter. Bond on count one will be stayed at $500 and on count two at $100. You are also arrested on an out-of-county warrant from Osceola County.
Okay.
For violation of probation.
Yeah.
And no bond was set on that warrant.
Okay.
So you will be held at no bond.
Okay.
Until you go to Osceola County. And there are a couple of them. So let me give you the case numbers. One is Osceola County case number 2019 CF 1960. I think that might be the only one. This one's 1960. I will appoint the public defender to represent you in both of these matters.
Okay.
There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days.
Okay.
Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
All right. Thank you.
Your Honor, Joseph Striplett, behavior.
Does he qualify for PTR?
Public defender, do you want me to have him reset?
Your Honor, I would not want to waive this one because he has no criminal convictions or FTAs, so I would be asking for ROR, but I know you probably don't want to do that without him being able to advise on the pretrial release condition. So if we could reset to tomorrow.
All right, I'll reset it tomorrow and we'll see if he's doing better. All right, could you tell me your name?
Marcos Borrayo Guerrero.
Sir, you were arrested on an out-of-county warrant out of Seminole County. There is no bond on the warrant. Let me see if it's only one. It is. Public defender, do you want me to appoint you temporarily to represent him?
Yes, Your Honor, we'd be asking that for all the out-of-county cases so we can attempt to get them bonds or maybe resolve their cases out of county.
All right.
That's what we've been doing.
Then I will appoint the public defender temporarily to represent you, just so the public defender knows. It looks like the underlying offense is attempted homicide. Have a good day, sir. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Good morning, Your Honor. Michael Cedeno.
Mr. Cedeno, you were arrested on an Osceola County warrant for violating your probation. No bond was set in that warrant. I will appoint the public defender to represent you in this matter. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am. All this would be, all this would be resolved out of county, correct?
It is an Osceola County case.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Tell me your name.
Jeffrey Gallego.
What happened to Kadir Daniels? Inmate number 2103001.
have him on the docket.
Bonded. All right, thank you. And you're Jeffrey Gallego?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Gallego, you were arrested for an out-of-county warrant?
Yes, ma'am, which I've tried to resolve. But due to the coronavirus, the clerk's office said that they are not working from the office.
Yeah.
And I wish to resolve.
Hold on just a second. It's out of Monroe County, and it's for an FWC violation again.
Correct, ma'am.
There is no bond set on the warrant. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days.
Okay.
All right. Do you have any questions?
What happens now?
What happens now is you will either be transported or they will try to get you a bond hearing here.
Okay.
All right?
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Tell me your name.
Ms. Hall.
Ms. Hall, you were arrested on an out-of-county warrant out of Jacksonville for theft of a controlled substance. A bond in the amount of $15,003 was set on that case. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
I guess so I'd be able to bond out.
The bond is set at $15,003.
How much that is?
That is
$15,003. Okay. It would be $1,500 with a bond. My heart. Sorry. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you. Sir, could you tell me your name?
Marcus Tyrell Henry.
Mr. Henry, you were arrested on a warrant out of Volusia County.
Yes.
For failure to appear. No bond was set on that warrant. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There is a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days.
Can I ask a question?
Absolutely.
While I was incarcerated, I had a court date for Volusia County. And they never brought me to court while I was in here, and I bonded out. Is that because of that, or did they have another court date?
I have absolutely no idea why the Volusia County judge issued the warrant. I might be able to tell you when it was issued. I may not.
Yes, I would like to see when it was issued.
It looks like it was issued on January 19th of 2021, but I'm not quite sure. All right? So you'll have to resolve that with the judge in Volusia County.
Yeah, is they ever going to come get me? Because I was in here for a while. They never came and got me.
The public defender can either resolve it with them or get a bond hearing if they don't come get you.
You'll be assigned a local attorney here. They don't represent you on the facts of the case, but they'll help you with the bond issue here.
Tell me your name.
Your Honor, Brittany Johnston, mental health.
It's an out-of-county warrant with no bond. Out of Santa Rosa County.
Your Honor, we can waive. The attorney who's assigned can explain to her.
All right, I will temporarily appoint the public defender to represent her and order that she be held on no bond until she's transported or there can be a bond hearing. Tell me your name, please, sir.
Mario Walker.
Mr. Walker, you were arrested on an out-of-county warrant, and it looks like that was out of Lake County, and no bond was set on the warrant. I will temporarily appoint the public defender to represent you in the matter here until they come and get you for Lake County.
Oh, so I'm going to be transported there because...
I don't know. Some county jails are transporting and some aren't. I don't know if Lake County's transporting or not.
Okay, so I had a bond and
It says no bond right there.
It said it's top.
Yeah, they put it wrong on there, so we always look at the teletype, which is there, and they put 2,000.
All right.
Yeah, they just put it wrong on the first page.
Looks like you have a $2,000 bond
correct.
That was issued. So you will be able to post a $2,000 bond.
Okay.
All right. Any other questions?
No, that will be all.
All right, great. Thank you.
All right.
Tell me your name. Tell me your name.
Wilfred Santiago.
Mr. Santiago, you were arrested for violating your probation. Going to set no bond on that violation of probation. I will appoint the public defender to represent you. There will be a $50 application fee. It will be due within 60 days. Do you have any questions?
No, Your Honor.
All right, thank you. Have a good day. And what about Mario McCree? Mario McCree? 2100-3034. Medical.
I'd ask to reset since this might be a case he can resolve.
All right. I'll reset him for tomorrow.
Oh.
Carl Williams. He was on Dr. T.
Carl Williams, I don't have anything on Mr. Williams.
We already did. Okay.
We did?
I don't have. Okay, anything. That's why he could.
I don't have any that I haven't done.
That's Google, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Your Honor?
Yeah.
Inmate McCree, he's medically.
I can't hear you.
He's medically quarantined. Well, his reset is approximately 14 days.
Who is?
McCree?
The last case we just addressed.
The last one?
He's COVID. He's quarantined for COVID precautions. So we won't be able to reset him for 2 weeks, is what they're right. saying.
So do you want to waive or do you want to reset?
If you'd release him on his own recognizance, I'd waive. Otherwise, reset.
All right. I'll order that it be reset after he's out of quarantine.
Thank you.
14 days.
Yeah, let's see. Just want to give a date. Maybe a week from Monday.
Yeah,
like the 15th.
That's the second time I've seen a criminal failure here. And they hit you with a new charge. Yeah. Pretty sure.
We're going to reset for the 15th and okay. see if he's out of quarantine by then.
Okay. But they can do it. I bet you he like showed up for trials and then like dipped. Mm-hmm. And then they, he probably dipped after jury selection.
Okay.
And then, so they issued a criminal failure to appear.
Okay.
Which is, okay. I'm going to appeal. Yeah, Monday's not going to be fun for y'all. Yeah.
It is always.
Although probably not here, though.
I appreciate it. I just want to make sure my paperwork was right.
Yeah, so when you get down there, it's going to be in there, but you know he bonded it, but yeah. We just got late notice, like
right.
3 hours. Yeah, 3 hours later.
Okay.
So you good.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh.
I found one more PTR form on that. Okay. So I just put it there.
Thank you.
I think it might be a good one. All right, see y'all in the morning.
Bye.
See you later. Oh, do I need to turn some of this off? I guess I do.
She's hitting you all.